In this video, we're going to describe how concentrated a solution is, but we're not going to use numbers. We're just going to do it qualitatively. So this will just be sort of a verbal description of how concentrated a solution is using words rather than numbers. So there's three words we have here, three descriptions: saturated, unsaturated, and supersaturated. And all three of these words will describe how concentrated our solution is. So as we go through this, maybe think about performing a simple task like making Kool-Aid, so dissolving sugar in water, where sugar is the solute and water, of course, is the solvent. So a saturated solution is a solution that contains the maximum amount of dissolved solute. It changes with temperature. The units are in grams of solute per 100 grams of water, or how much sugar can we dissolve in 100 grams of water. And if we add additional solute to a saturated solution, that additional solute will not dissolve. And that makes sense because the solution already contains the maximum amount. So if we add any more, well, that will just fall to the bottom of the flask. So a saturated solution would be like drinking Kool-Aid that dissolved as much sugar as you could. So it would be very sweet. An unsaturated solution is a solution that contains less solute than the saturation amount. So that's like having Kool-Aid that's not very sweet. And of course, additional solute will dissolve. So if it contains less than the maximum amount, if you add more sugar, that sugar will dissolve. And the third kind of solution we have is a supersaturated solution. This one is the most challenging to understand. It's also the least common. That's a solution that contains more solute than the saturation amount. Now you're probably thinking, well, how can a solution contain more than the maximum amount? Well, the reason why it can do that is because a supersaturated solution is unstable and it's temporary. So it won't stay a supersaturated solution for very long. So if we have a supersaturated solution and we add additional solute, not only will that additional solute not dissolve, but in fact, it will cause crystallization. Here's a classic example of a supersaturated solution. This is a salt called sodium acetate. It's a white powder, and it readily dissolves in water. So to make a supersaturated solution, what you would do is you would dissolve sodium acetate in hot water. And you would create a saturated solution at an elevated temperature. And then what you would allow the flask to do is to cool down. And we already decided that the saturation amount changes with temperature. You know just through your own experiences that a warm liquid will dissolve more solute than a cool liquid. So remember, what we've done is we've taken hot water and we've dissolved enough sodium acetate to make a saturated solution. And then we'll allow this flask to cool, maybe down to like room temperature. So now what we have is a situation where this is actually supersaturated in here, and any type of agitation, like shaking of the flask or introducing another crystal, maybe just one little speck, well, that will cause crystallization of the entire volume here. It's pretty neat, and it releases a lot of heat. It's an exothermic reaction. If you go on YouTube, you can see a variety of sodium acetate supersaturation demos.